Now open, Mary, Our Lady of Peace Mausoleum in Flushing, New York. Secure your family's future with 10% down, no taxes, and 0% interest financing for up to 10 years on pre-need crypts and cremation niches starting at just $25 per month. Protect your loved ones with the gift of pre-planning. Visit them today at Mount St. Mary Cemetery. Call 718-353-1560. That's 718-353-1560. Or go to ccbklyn.org to learn more. That's ccbklyn.org.
Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
Arraigned, a stoned-faced mayor, Eric Adams, walks into federal court a short time ago with no comment.
Mayor, how you feeling?
And that drumbeat of whether or not he's going to resign, which is inevitable, will continue in the days and weeks ahead. Adams pleading not guilty to corruption charges, ordered to stay away from witnesses and anyone involved in this historic case. As you already know, His Honor, the first sitting New York City mayor to be criminally indicted, and he stared with a blank look on his face ahead as the judge fired off the conspiracy, wire fraud, and bribery allegations he is facing. Bravo to Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu at the United Nations, the General Assembly, blasting them as a swamp of anti-Semitic bile in a fiery speech. Dozens of diplomats walk out, so be it. He issued a stern threat to Iran during his address before the UN General Assembly Friday morning. The number to reach me, and let's go ahead and open up the phone lines, 800-848-9222, 800-848-9222. And as well, former President Trump meets with President Zelensky of Ukraine. We'll bring that to you. I am not guilty, Your Honor, Adams told the federal magistrate judge, Catherine Parker. The judge ordered that Adams be released. He was released by the court, but not before warning him to stay away from people named in the indictment against him, as well as witnesses in his case. Prosecutors agreed to work with Adams' lawyers on accommodations for him to speak with members of his family and staff who may know facts of the case, but not anything pertaining to the allegations. The judge added, and this had to be very humiliating for the mayor of New York, the judge, and I'm stating here, I'm obligated to warn you that if you fail to appear in court, a warrant will be issued for your arrest. So the mayor's schedule goes out the window. Whenever he has to appear in court, he has to be there. And that is the bottom line. He walked in a navy suit, maroon tie, and sat calmly with his hands folded in his lap for much of the proceeding. At the end of it, Adam stood up, buttoned his jacket, and offered a grim, small smile to a nearby court officer before being escorted out of the packed courtroom by U.S. Marshals. We're going to start with your telephone calls in just 1 second, but Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, bravo, bravo, denouncing the United Nations General Assembly as a swamp of anti-Semitic bile during a fiery address this morning. And he slammed the mounting criticism of Israel's handling of the nearly year-long war against Hamas in the Gaza Strip. And I want you to listen to this, folks. This is Netanyahu this morning at the United Nations General Assembly.
The singling out of the one and only Jewish state continues to be a moral stain on the United Nations. It has made this once respected institution contemptible in the eyes of decent people everywhere. But for the Palestinians, this UN house of darkness is home court. They know that in this swamp of anti-Semitic bile, there's an automatic majority willing to demonize the Jewish state on anything. In this anti-Israel, flat earth society, any false charge, any outlandish allegation can muster a majority. In the last decade, there have been more resolutions passed against Israel in this hall at the UN General Assembly than against the entire world combined. Actually, more than twice as many. Since 2014, this body condemned Israel 174 times. It condemned all the other countries in the world 73 times. That's more than 100 extra condemnations for the Jewish state. What hypocrisy. What a double standard. What a joke.
And that's the Prime Minister calling it like it is before the United Nations General Assembly. We've got to get to Trump in Ukraine, meeting with Zelensky. A lot of things going on this Friday. I see all of your calls. We're about to begin with them. But you cannot believe the cojones, right? And I normally wouldn't you on Nathan Wade, right? Nathan Wade, who happens to be the secret lover, undercover lover of District Attorney Fannie Willis in Georgia. And this song right here is dedicated to the lovebirds.
You got what I need.
Oh, yeah. Fannie said he was just a friend. Remember? Fannie said that Nathan Wade was just a friend. Remember that, folks? Oh, they thought they had Trump on a platter. Boo, boo. What do you want me to do for your career? I want to be the lead prosecutor on Trump. Well, sweetie, you don't have any experience doing that. You know what? We're going to make it happen anyway. This is their theme song. This is their theme song. And so I want you to hear shot number one. The cojones on this guy, right? They're investigating Fannie now, right? She was reelected, but she might not be district attorney in the future because she's under investigation. And they couldn't find this guy. This guy, her boo, Nathan Wade, disappeared. Listen to how this was covered on Fox News.
Lover boy, Nathan Wade is missing. The House Judiciary Committee, which is investigating Georgia DA Fannie Willis, needs Wade to testify at a hearing tomorrow on their love affair. But no one can find the guy. They're trying to serve him, but he's flown the coop. And now the U.S. Marshals are in a manhunt to track him down. Have they checked the condo?
And so the government had to get the U.S. Marshals. Look at how bold these two are with their lies. Oh, we're not lovers. Oh, we're caught red-handed. We're lovers. Oh, I'm firing him from the case. Oh, he's fired from the case. Your daughter gets arrested. Oh, you and Nathan Wade show up together, even though you told us that the relationship was over. Do you think we're absolute fools? And so in his defiance, remember, this is the same guy when a Post reporter came up to him, showed a gun, which is not against the law in Georgia. He had a gun in his possession, trying to intimidate the reporter. And so they couldn't find this guy to serve him with a subpoena. The good news is the U.S. Marshals got involved. He realized that this was not a joke. Oops. All of a sudden, they found Nathan Wade. Her boo has been served with a subpoena and is going to be forced to testify. Let's start with your telephone calls on this Friday. Let's begin with Edward in Tampa, Florida. What's on your mind, Edward?
Yeah, Dominic, Ms. Harris going to the border is a little bit late. She needs to check out South Africa. They are taking people into custody that are working illegally in restaurants and businesses. She's late to the ballgame, Dominic.
She's definitely late to the ball game at the border, and Trump is surging in the polls. I've told you folks consistently, he's going back to the White House. Look at what Zelensky did, hedging his bet, meeting with Kamala Harris, right? But also making sure that he went to Trump Tower to meet with Trump. We're going to be playing some of that coming up in the next couple of minutes. And, of course, coming up at 50 minutes past the hour, the great Curtis Sliwa will be joining me for his segment. Let's go to Jeff in New Jersey. Jeff, what's on your mind on this Friday?
Good afternoon, Dominic. Great show. And I listen to you at midnight as well. Can't get enough of your common sense.
Thank you.
Did Eric Adams have to post bail because all the criminals that they're letting out don't have to post bail?
Well, remember, this is the federal system. It's not the state system where the no cash bail laws apply directly. He didn't have to post bail. No mayor of New York City would have to post bail. And, you know, he walked out, but it's humiliating. And the clock is ticking, and Governor Hochul, who has the power to remove him, she's not going to do it, but she's talking a little tough, and she says she's going to give the mayor a couple of days to think about things. All I can say to that, Jeff, and thank you for the call, and thank you for the kind words, is tick-tock, tick-tock. I'm not trying to be mean to the mayor. The money is about to dry up the same way they did to Biden. He will be resigning. He can fight and be in denial as long. Same things I said about Biden, that he could be in denial as long as he want. He can say publicly that he's not going to drop out. What happened at the end of the day, folks? Bye-bye. Let's go to Anthony in Manhattan. Anthony, what's on your mind?
Dominic, how you doing? This is Anthony with ALT Flags. How are you?
Oh, Anthony, you are the man. Anthony, wait a minute now. Can I say what you do for a living?
Absolutely.
Anthony is a New York City police officer. So I go out to the Whitestone Republican Club and, you know, regular event. And I was looking forward to chatting with council member Vicky Palladino. And Anthony comes up, and Anthony, when you do what I do, you receive a lot of gifts, and, you know, we have to be careful what we accept because we have rules that we have to follow. But Anthony gives me the best gift I have ever received in my life, right? And Anthony is so unassuming, and he gives me a wooden flag, the flags that he makes. Folks, you got to look at his work. And on the bottom, he has my name on it. And I got to tell you, Anthony, up in my home proudly, and generally at my home, I don't put anything up outside of my office that pertains to my career, because at home, it's about my family. It's not about me. So I don't put up stuff, any gifts that I've received, right? But yours is the only one that I have up proudly as soon as you enter into my home, the flag that you gave me. Go ahead, Anthony.
That really means a lot to me. And, you know, speaking about your family, I just finished your book. It was so amazing. I loved your book. And really quickly, happy birthday to your son, which is tomorrow, which I found out through the book.
Wow. You are correct. It's my son's birthday tomorrow, Dominic Jr. And while I'm working, he's up at the outlet mall with his mom, and they're having lunch and they're doing some shopping, and we're going to try and celebrate it tomorrow. But yes, Anthony, you have, I'm late for a break, but I want you to do me a favor. I have to end the call right now. I definitely want to have a conversation with you. So either next week, early next week, call same time, early show or late show, you do phenomenal work, and you're so unassuming, a New York City police officer, you're so professional, your social media work is outstanding, the stuff that you put on Instagram. I've got to chat with you next week, okay? Is that okay?
I love you, Dominic. That sounds wonderful. Thank you so much for taking my call.
Thank you, Anthony. And to folks that are interested in my book, it's No Mama's Boy. You can get it at my personal website where I can personally sign it for you, which is DominicCarterOnline.com. DominicCarterOnline.com. A bunch of books went out this week. You can also order my book from the WABC store. We have got to take a break, and we are coming right back on this Friday.
This is Dominic Carter. Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
And we are back. This song is going out to Atlanta, Georgia, to Fonnie Willis and Nathan Wade. Turn it up, turn it up. Oh, this applies. It applies. This is Fonnie. This is Fonnie. This is Fonnie. The district attorney. And hope that you're okay, Nathan Wade. I know you were married at the time. Before anyone gets home, please call. That's Fonnie by the phone. The district attorney that thought she was going to get Trump. How could something so wrong be so right? Boy, they are in such love with each other. She made him the lead prosecutor on Trump. Oops, it didn't work. Then they lied about their little bump in the bed. Oops, the public found out. She went to the black church and said, "How dare you ask me questions like this?" Oops, the bone was coming out of her mouth. They were lovers. Yes, Tiffany and Nathan Wade. So I'm looking, I didn't sing, I'm looking at my Twitter. David Hun says, "Dominic, don't listen to those people that tell you not to sing. I love when you sing. I think it's great." Thank you, David. I can't sing. We all know that. Let's go back to the phones. And the reason why I'm focusing on this, he loves his boo so much. You know, remember she reimbursed him cash for all those great trips with all that taxpayer money. They tried to serve him a subpoena. She may end up losing her job. She's under investigation. And Nathan Wade said, "Not my boo." They couldn't find him to serve him with a subpoena. The U.S. Marshals had to get involved and serve this guy last night. Russ in White Plains, what's on your mind?
Dominic, to me, for Adams, a victory is finishing his term, because I think he's rebranding himself. He's now the Trump of Brooklyn, and he's taken a hit for New Yorkers, because when he allowed migrants to come in here and he said, "Hey, it's too much for us," and Biden turned his back on him and the DOJ started taking his phones, he's being treated like Trump. Trump was on TV basically saying the same thing. These Gestapo raids on Gracie Mansion, just like with Navarro and Trump and Roger Stone. This is insane. John Liu survived these same bundling charges. And what I want to know is, do you think someday Trump would pardon Adams? Because, you know,
He might. Thank you, Russ. It's Friday. He might pardon him if Trump is in office. He did pardon the African-American mayor of Detroit. But the fact of the matter is, Adams has got big problems. We're coming right back.
Now, from New York City to the world, it's Dominic Carter.
And we are back on this Friday. I'm looking at my Twitter, at my X, which is @DominicTV. And by the way, folks, our great social media staff has just put up a video clip of me discussing the Eric Adams situation. You can go on TikTok to @WABC Radio and see it, or you can go to my TikTok, which is @DominicTVTV. So DMS, she says, "Any chance you could share," this is on Twitter, "Anthony's Instagram address so we can see his work?" I will do. DMS, thank you for all your tweets and all your kind words all the time. I will do as soon as the program is over. We are live, of course. And this NYPD police officer, his American flags, he's given one to Sid Rosenberg here in New York. His work of American flags, it is phenomenal. And he had it personally engraved in wood at the bottom with my name, Dominic Carter, on. And up at my house, it's one of the only gifts. Because, again, I have a firm rule. I try not to put up many photos of me or photos with me and celebrities, because I believe that my home should be about my kids and my wife and my family. But his work, Anthony's flag, is one of the things that I have up at my home. So the weekend schedule, before we get right back, coming up tomorrow, 4 to 5 p.m., of course, left versus right, former Congressman Anthony Weiner and myself. And what's coming up on Sunday, folks, the big Tunnel to Towers Foundation walk run this Sunday, September 29th. And all of us here at Red Apple Audio Networks are encouraging our loyal listeners to donate to our individual teams. You can go to walk.dominiccartershow.com and click on my picture to donate. This is serious work done by serious people. Last year, the Dominic Carter team came in first place with this charity, and we're running neck and neck. We're close to being first again this year. Curtis Sliwell, who's coming up in about 15 minutes to join me, is giving me a run for my money because he has his wife, Nancy. Nancy's the superstar that does all the work and the brains behind operations for many of us here at the radio station. And so Nancy's working on behalf of her husband, and I'm trying to make sure that they don't beat me this year, folks. So please, let's raise some money for the Tunnel to Towers Foundation. This is the last weekend with this event. This is for our veterans, for our first responders, and 9/11 victims. That's walk.dominiccartershow.com. Click on my picture to donate. Every dollar helps. President Zelensky of Ukraine traveling to Trump Towers to meet with former President Donald Trump today, and this is what each leader had to say.
What do you envision is fair?
Well, it's too early to say that. I mean, I have my own ideas, and I'm sure the president definitely has his own ideas, but it has to be fair.
This war shouldn't be started, and I think that the problem that Putin killed so many people, and of course we need to do everything to pressure him to stop this war, and he is on our territory. That is the most important to understand. He is on our territory, and how to stop the war, to pressure him as we can, we have to do it.
Interesting. Zelensky traveling to meet with Trump. And of course, Trump says he will end this war immediately. Their comments continued.
President Trump, have you changed your thoughts on how this war should end, what you think should be done, or do you still stand by some of the previous things?
Well, I learned a lot, but I think I haven't changed from the standpoint that we both want to see this end, and we both want to see a fair deal made. And it's got to be fair. And I think that'll happen at the right time. I think it's going to happen. The president wants it to end, and he wants it to end as quickly as possible. He wants a fair transaction to take place.
Trump and Zelensky meeting with each other today. A lot of you, as it relates to Mayor Eric Adams' situation, have wondered about the man that would take over should Adams be forced to resign. That's public advocate, based on the city charter, public advocate Jemani Williams. Now, he is far, 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 far left. He makes Adams look like a conservative. I want you to listen to something that he said as it relates to protesting. This is Jemani Williams, and letting steam run off, letting people exercise their point of view. Listen to this.
We are going to have to accept some discomfort in the next few days. That's what we're going to have to do as a city to get through this. And so I'm asking the mayor and the police commissioner to allow people to express their anger, to allow people to express their pain. And as a city, we have to accept that we are going to be in some discomfort for the next few days. And the only thing we should be asking is, how do we address the pain and how do we address the anger? And as long as the leaders are from the community making the decisions, we should all be supportive.
That's who your mayor would be. I'm looking at my emails. Liz Rosenblatt. Liz says, Dominic, it just came in here. You are so refreshing and full of energy. You make the beginning of the weekend so great. Thank you for your amazing shows. Good luck this Sunday. I believe you will win. We've got Liz from Florida. Thank you, Liz. We've got to beat Curtis Sliwa. Not his wife, Nancy. Curtis. It's me against Curtis. One of us is going to win. One of us is going to lose. And the agony of defeat. Remember that from Wide World of Sports on ABC? Let's go back to your telephone calls on this Friday. Dennis on Long Island, what's on your mind?
Hey, Dominic, how are you? Quick, listen, you know what the conviction rate for the feds is in the Eastern District, U.S. Court, Southern District Court is?
Well, in most courts, state or federal, the conviction rate is very, very, very high because most people are not stupid and they'll take the plea bargain, right? So in the Southern District, I believe it's the high 90s. I will say again, Dennis, I was an in-bed reporter, meaning I was assigned there full-time every day from 9 to 5, every day, covering the Southern District, the courts. Those folks don't play. If they're coming to get you, good luck with that. And that's all I can say. They would not have brought this case against Adams unless they could dot every I and cross every T. So the conviction rate is up there. Dennis, thank you for the call. Sandra in New Jersey. What's on your mind, Sandra?
Oh, Dominic, I wasn't going to call today, but when I heard that beautiful call that Anthony made about your book, I said, I had a call. I had to say ditto. That book was so great, Dominic, that I like to work out. I go to the gym, and my least favorite exercise is the treadmill. Do you know that I would read your book on the treadmill, and I wouldn't want to get off? The time went far more than what I usually do.
Well, if it motivated you, Sandra, to stay on the treadmill, that's a good thing. You and I share that in common. I hate the treadmill. But guess what? I shouldn't say this. I hate gyms. But the treadmill, you know, I can do it for maybe a week. And, you know, we at the station here, we got all these great-looking guys walking around, Diego and so on, and Rich and all the guys, and Chris Libertini. Chris Libertini, I call Chris Libertini, so you know, Sandra, he's the mad scientist. This guy is the genius that works 20 hours a day emailing me, I got an idea for a great promo. I got an idea for a great open. Everything you hear on the radio station, Chris Libertini is the guy that puts it all together in his room. And now he has Doug and Philippe and the social media people. Sandra, I'm going to let you finish before I move on to the next call. You hear me on the radio, but believe me when I tell you, there are a lot of people that go into this hour and every hour that you hear on the radio where they do like 5 times much more work and harder work than I do. And I haven't even gotten into management with the Casamatidis and our president, Chad Lopez. But of course, the Casamatidis, Margot Casamatidis, she is the biggest reason. So why I'm here. You talk about, and of course her husband, but you talk about my book. And Sandra, I have to admit this to you, and I think you know you read the book. There are a lot of embarrassing things in the book for any one person to be forced to admit, but I felt that I had no choice so that I could try and help others. Please go ahead before I go on to the next call.
Okay. I loved your book, and I want Anthony and all your other loyal callers to come to this event at the end of the month. So today I'll just leave the phone number. It's so easy. Ask for Irene, 212-582-5454, extension 3. That's the Women's National Republican Club. Call, make a reservation, get to meet Dominic in person. How could you beat that, Dominic?
Well, thank you. Thank you, Sandra. I am going to be there. I'm be there, be square. I promise that when I commit to something, you're going to get all that I've got. And that means my energy. Now, of course, I have a show to do that night once we're done. But if for those of you that want to have the banter that we have on the radio, it's going to be happening that night live, and it's October 29th or 27th.
That's right. October 29th, Tuesday at 6 o'clock. It's at 3 West 51st Street, Midtown. So easy. There's a parking lot right around the corner. And if you want to call, you take the number 212-582-5454, extension 3, or you could go to membership at WNRC.org and get your tickets that way.
Fantastic. I look forward to it, Sandra. Thank you. Have a great weekend. Let's go to Dave in Orange County, I believe, New York, line three. What's on your mind, Dave?
Hey, what's going on, Dominic? How you doing, bud?
Good, good. Please go right ahead.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, you know what? That the heckler that was heckling Adams, Mayor Adams, at the when he was saying it was a black thing, and the guy was saying, no, it's a you thing. You know, that, I don't know who that is, and I heard that he might be a BLM guy, might be a bad guy, but I tell you what, he was kicking back. He, you know, he really laid it out, and he had him pegged.
But you know what, Dave? There's a place for everything, right? And that was a cheap shot. You don't do that. Mayor Adams is down right now, and you don't kick somebody when they're down. You had national networks about to go live momentarily to take Adams, and this is why these nuts do it. And all this guy is thinking about, what you say, he was right on the facts. So he embarrassed Adams and the city of New York before a national audience with that heckling. And this man, listen, you could say Adams is a great mayor, you could say he's a bad mayor, but you don't kick somebody when they're down. And right now he's down. Let the man have his news conference, let him have his say, and that's that. You know, even with that event, Dave, right, I felt bad for Adams because many seasoned, maybe, I don't want to use the word elderly, members of black leadership that was there with him. But notice, as I said the other day, who was not standing there? The Reverend Al Sharpton. And so I just felt bad for Adams at that event. And I don't think that guy made himself look good or the city of New York. Dave, quickly, final thought. Go ahead.
You know what, though? This is New York. You do kick him when he's down. And especially somebody that deserves it. He takes every opportunity to talk smack in front of all the reporters and everything like that, right? So, you know what? In New York, you're down, you kick him down, you keep on kicking him.
Nah. Okay, we disagree. We disagree on that, man. I respect you, Dave, what you're saying. I believe you treat people the way that you want to be treated. And right now, Mayor Adams is in the battle of his life. He's going to be forced to resign. He's going to go from 5,000, meaning popularity level and within himself, self-esteem, all the way down to zero. And you don't do that at this time. The man is looking at the potential of jail time. He's going to lose his job. What else more do we want? Folks, we've got to take a break on this Friday. When we come back, the legend is going to join us. Curtis Sliwa is standing by, and he really is a legend. We are coming right back.
This is Dominic Carter. And now, it's time for the Tunnel to Towers Foundation. Final thoughts.
And folks, the Tunnel to Towers Foundation is the real deal. These folks deliver. Let me be very clear about that. And with me right now, the legend, he doesn't like when I say that, but the legend himself, Curtis Sliwa. What's going on today, brother?
You know how I always say, Dominic, I never forgive and I never forget.
Yes.
My chief nemesis in the Adams administration, a woman who advocated that I be fired or suspended on numerous occasions, Eric Adams, Svengali Rasputin, chief advisor Ingrid Lewis Martin, was stopped at the airport by Southern District Department of Justice personnel and FBI as she returned from a trip to Japan, stripped of all of her cell phones and her laptop computer after they had visited her house early on to serve subpoenas and found out she had not yet returned.
Wow. 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 Where does all of this stop, Curtis? I mean, it's like, if you're Mayor Adams, this keeps going from bad to worse.
Yep. And remember, let's be honest out there, ladies and gentlemen. I've kept you ahead of the curve on each and every one of these situations.
You have.
I've never met personally with the Southern District or the Eastern District, but I know they listen intently.
Hey, Curtis, wait. I want you to be honest with our audience.
Yes.
On all of this information that you have revealed, you and I often, we're in the same area working, and I look at you sometimes like you got two heads when you tell me the information. And doggone it, everything that you have told me has turned out to be dead on accurate, even though I was hesitant on some of it when you...
Oh, there's no doubt because, Dominic, you were aware of these folks as New York City's top political reporter for years at New York One, the face and the voice of New York One. Everybody knew you, and everybody obviously wanted to be interviewed by Dominic Carter, whether it was good times or bad times. In another development, and I had explained to all of you what would happen with Sheena Wright, who is the deputy mayor, number two to Eric Adams, she also had her phones taken. Her home was raided. She is, I would say, the longtime Amour love interest, has lived with the chancellor of the Department of Education, dumbest organization ever, David Banks, who himself had his phones taken and announced his retirement at the end of the year. They have just issued an executive order. Eric Adams signed it. That if Sheena Wright, who's the number two person in the administration, leaves, they have described what will happen if she is unable to carry out her duties. And that then the deputy mayor for Health and Human Services, Ann Williams Isom, replaces her. So they know she's going to be out. And
okay,
she-
so wait a minute. When you say if she leaves, that sounds like somebody may be arrested possibly.
Well, there's no doubt. Look, the time I've told you is running out. If Trump is elected president, all of these investigations, all of these seizures will cease. You saw President Donald Trump last night throw a lifeline out to Eric Adams.
He sure did.
And so Damian Williams, who is cut out of the mold of Rudy Giuliani in terms of high-profile cases, knows that if Donald Trump is sworn into office January 20th, he will be relieved of his duties. He will not be rehired. So pressure must be applied to Eric Adams now. They'll never be able to try him this quickly. So what they're going to hope to do is pressure him so much that he'll want to resign, or that Hochul will fire him because he'll make a deal. He'll make a, what they call a plea deal for all of these people. If I leave, well, does that mean Ingrid is okay? Does that mean Sheena Wright is okay? Does that mean he'll try to keep each and every one of these people out of harm's way, because if they go to trial, they'll become cooperating witnesses, and he'll be going away to jail for a long time in the cell of P. Diddy and R. Kelly.
Well, the bottom line, again, you have been accurate, dead on accurate, on each and every, you've been months ahead, you're making all the rest of us that are members of the Fourth Estate look stupid and lazy. In terms of you had all this information, Curtis, and so we'll see what you're going to be reporting next. Thank you for doing
remember,
so. Hey,
remember,
how we
Dominic,
doing with Tunnel to Towers? Who's winning, me or you?
No, it's neck and neck for Sunday, and Nancy is slightly ahead of you, Dominic.
Oh, I'm ending this way. I still love you, man. I love you.
Just lucky you're a friend and not a foe, because...
yeah, Don't investigate me.
That's right. I never forgive. I never forget. Remember that, Adams.
Have a great weekend, folks.